And as we get set for the game in Vancouver, this was the warm-up. Tim Stützle blew a tire, and Brady Tkachuk didn't miss a beat.
You know that happens, and this is one of the things when people ask me what I miss about retirement. It's the camaraderie, and Brady Tkachuk, you know he loves to give it to the youngster. That's when you know you're one of the boys.
Tim Stützle during the TV timeout goes over and has a little conversation, or not even a conversation, a look.
Roommates
with his buddy,
his landlord,
Brady Tkachuk, a little smile, laughing at each other. But listen, it's a long season, and I'm sure there's an inside joke in there somewhere. Tim Stützle, who's very close with Brady Tkachuk, introducing himself to the family in warm up. Two brothers having a conversation, and slides in to say hello. Serious when you're meeting the family, I guess.
Yeah, I know. It's almost like meeting the in-laws, isn't it?
And Chris, as you mentioned, Tyler Seguin will start at center on the top line with Benn and Radulov. And this is a little gamesmanship before, after the warm-up, this game got started. Tyler Seguin wanted to be the last one off. David Rittich says, wait a second, comes back and plays peekaboo a bit to say, okay, you know what, you can have it this time. But this goes to show you where the head of Tyler Seguin is coming into this game number two, very much ready to get going.
Gamesmanship going on in pregame. Who's going to leave the ice last? Brad Marchand refuses to, so does Mika Zibanejad. This has been going on for more than 4 minutes on the garden ice, and Mika Zibanejad will not leave his home ice until and unless Brad Marchand leaves first. He will not leave the ice. Cheers, Brad Marchand. They are still out there. As you can see, the Zamboni's on the ice. And Mika Zibanejad and Brad Marchand refuse to leave. This is a live shot from inside Madison Square Garden, and Mika Zibanejad's skates are still on the ice, as are Brad Marchand's.
Marchand knows it's his ice, and he's trying to take it from him, and Zibanejad's not going to let him. And yes, it is superstition.
The Zamboni is done. These two players are not.
Everybody's off besides these two. So Marchand's all the way down where the Zamboni comes out, and the Bruins leave and enter the ice. And then they say, well, here's how we're going to decide this. And guess who wins? Zibanejad wins. Let's hope that's the start of something great.
Sid undoes the skate and then does it up in one knee. Everybody did it at the same time. It was awesome.
That is good. That's awesome.
Put the puck ahead. Niskanen, a good read, knocked it away, but Deneau gets it back, shoots, and scores. Into the empty net, Deneau, and there will be a game six, and right now we have a scrum. It's turning into a melee.
Might as well get your shots in while you can, boys.
Just don't do anything that would affect your availability for game six. Right.
Jake Voracek has Shea Weber, I believe, and Weber has trashed a few flyers in this game and gotten away with it, especially Kevin Hayes. Do what you got to do.
Looked like Shane Victorino jumping into the pile when the Phillies won the World Series. He just went airborne in there.
Yeah. Difference being this isn't quite a celebration.
No celebration there.
That one goes right into the Red Wings bench.
And takes two of them out.
Somebody saw it coming, leaned back, and you can see that's Larkin. Whoa.
And Bobby Ryan.
Kind of laughing about it now, but
when one guy tips over, other ones go too.
That's a first for me. There's going to be a meme for sure.
Now, there's a great ceremony that a lot of teams do, but the Vancouver Canucks have done for many years. The sweaters off our backs night is still coming, so the fans are still here, but they still seem to me like they're anticipating another chance for a great ovation, maybe for Trevor Linden and Marcus Naslund, but certainly for Linden, because very few people have gone.
And all his teammates. There's Roberto Luongo getting his congratulations. A great career.
He hasn't said it, but it's pretty obvious.
But the pictures say the words, don't they? And I think Jerome Iginla and some of the Flames are waiting to give their piece as well. What a class act.
Isn't this terrific?
Thank you.
The other Flames that went to the dressing room were all coming back out.
Again, the class of Jerome McGinley and the rest of his teammates exuding here.
I hope you heard what he said to Jerome McGinley when he passed him. He said, "You're the best player in the game." Former teammate Adrian Acorn.
The game's about passion. The game's about intensity. It's also about respect.
In tonight's game, Sharks forward Patrick Marleau has tied Gordie Howe's all-time NHL games played record, amassing 1,767 NHL games over his historic career that includes 566 goals, 1,196 points, and 3 All-Star appearances. Wild fans, let's hear it for Patrick Marleau and this incredible milestone.
Five-two, the final for Minnesota, and the Wild players shake hands with Patrick Marleau, who will break the NHL record on Monday. Tonight, it's all about Minnesota. It's official now. Blada's first shift of the game is 1,768 of his NHL career. And he's gone past Gordie Howe for number one all time. Here's public address announcer Bruce Cusick.
Patrick Marleau has played in his 1,768th NHL regular season game, surpassing Hockey Hall of Famer Gordie Howe, and is now the NHL's all-time leader in games played.
Well, and as you see on this historic night, all the Golden Knights over to shake the hand of Patrick Marleau, number one all-time in the history of the NHL in games played at 1,768.
Well deserved by him, and certainly the respect from all the Golden Knights players for a record, Dave, that we certainly, I don't know if we'll ever see it broken. You and I won't if it happens again. And there's him and Fleury with two great players that could go to the same place when their career is over. The Hall of Fame.
No question about it. All the Golden Knights, stick taps staying on the ice. And the crowd here at the Fortress, capacity these days, 3,950. To salute a great accomplishment. There's the family of Patrick Marleau, family and friends in attendance tonight. On a night we may never see again, someone taking over the all-time games played list in NHL history. Patrick Marleau now number one all-time.
We've talked about all night long, Dave. It's one of those records that wondered if it was ever be broken. How does it happen? Certainly consistency, health, his ability to play that long, that many games. But it's not only the 1,768. I'm still amazed. That's now 898 straight consecutive games. To do that, certainly it's not without injury. There are bumps and bruises and things you have to fight through along the way. The conditioning, the shape you have to be in, the mental toughness, just all those